When this particular thing was being invited, like I need to speak about the topic of the clinical Rashastra, I asked her, like, what should I discuss there? Anything clinical. So I thought initially, let me speak about something about respiratory system or oncology, or let me speak about something like arthritis, autoimmune disease, anything. Later I came to know it's instead, let me make it a huge cocktail of mixing up all the clinical cases, because every case is equally important, whether it is a rhinitis or a case related to oncology, because only the patient knows what's the real suffering of illness. So on that grounds, I started to compile the things and make it into one slot, and I try my best to complete it within time or try to cut it off in the last. So we'll run through the slides. Next, please. So as Ayurveda believes about the shrotas, everything is depending on the shrotas. Whether you want to have a vruddhi lakshan, you want to have kshaya lakshan, any deviation or any pathology to occur, it is through the channels, through the shrotas. So we would like to see something like the treatment protocol is being pinpointed very specifically to either of these shrotas, so that you have the action in a very quicker way. You have it in a very quicker way, and you should be more specific. Most of these things are related directly from the classical textbooks of Rasa Shastra, and also have gained lots of encouragement once I see the Karmanusara classification of Sushruta. So on that grounds we try to go, and every shrotas will be elated with few of the clinical case discussions before and after treatment reports. Next, please. Salutation to the God, Dhanavantri and Lord Shiva himself, without which we are nowhere. The shrotas, the definitions and all, people know it very well. I would not like to go into the deepest part of the slokas and definitions. We'll go directly into the clinical trials. Next, please. In case if a person want to be more swastha, because before you land up into pathology, you should know the physiology. Before you need to enter into the department of roga vignana or kachikitsa, you should know about the kriya sharira. So on that grounds, as I say, you need to maintain the health in and healthy, you need to do the swastha palana. But according to Rasa Shastra, what is swastha palana? Anandakanda speaks about people should take regular paradhan gandaka. People here are scared to take paradhan gandaka for once in a lifetime when they really fall ill. But the textbook speaks about giving paradhan gandaka for lifetime. This is a reference from Anandakanda, wherein you want to become a swastha purusha, you are supposed to take paradhan gandaka. Second thing is a shatrasa dravyas. These were Vaikrantha and Vajra, or two shatrasa dravyas. Every of my slide will be having the reference there. I will not be reading them. As you see, Ayurveda Prakasham Rasadharangini, chapter number and shloka number. So this will be the protocol for the whole of the presentation. Please go through them later whenever you have the time. Next. These are the rasayana dravyas which we need to take on the grounds of Rasa Shastra. In case if we don't take either of these things, we might fall ill. It can be a minor pathology or a grave pathology like this. Next. For which you might need Ayusha set of drugs, wherein you need to elongate your lifespan. Next. One of the prime thing is a Ghrita. Once you speak about the Rasaushadis, common protocol what we give as an Anupanam is usually Ghrita. Sometimes we give it with Madhu. Of course, Roganusara, it's definitely there. You're not very particular where you are very specific about something like Medhya, or you are very specific like you want to have its action, especially in the brain, then we need to give it with Ghrita. That's a very, very good mode of action of the drugs which we can appreciate. Next, please. In case if we don't do, there is lots of disturbances in the body. In case if the swasthita is not maintained, lots of disturbance, either it is in doshic level or elsewhere, then it lands up to the grave disorders like this. Next. This is a case of squamous cell carcinoma. This is very common nowadays. As I say, inspired with the preparation called as a Roma Shatha Yoga from our text itself, wherein Haratala is the chief ingredient. Why Haratala is being used here in Roma Shatana Yoga? Because it causes the necrosis, the local necrosis of the area. So this is an advantage. In squamous cell carcinoma, you have an altered cell lining there. Why don't you do necrosis of that area? I'll say many of the times, metastasis is comparatively very less in squamous cell carcinoma. Most of the times it is a affected area which goes deeper and deeper and further deteriorates the patient. That's a different aspect. So on this grounds, what I did is I started to apply arsenic preparations, I usually go for either Shilagarbha or Mallagarbha Kottali and apply to the local area, because Acharya Sushruta has explained among the Shashtyupakarmas in Vrhadachikitsa, Lepana. So I use these Lepanas of Rasaushadis in all squamous cell carcinoma cases, and this patient is totally fine. You see how beautifully the squamous cell has been necrotized. Next please. See, and the whole of thing will get snuffed off. The whole of that squamatized area is being snuffed off and the patient is fine. Next please. You can see the lepa there. This is Shilagarbha Kottali. So by the time the patient has come towards the ulceration, next please. The ulceration was around 6 inches. By the time he left, it was hardly 1 inch. So we have given a very good improvement. Of course, the patient was not on any chemotherapy, was not on radiation, absolutely no. He was only on Ayurvedic preparations. Added to this, we go with the treatment protocol if we want to gain a success. There are four steps where we need to understand it. One thing is the swastha palana, which we have just discussed now. So to maintain the swasthya, we need to take any of these rasaushadis for the longevity of life. The second thing is a shrotu dushti lakshana, which has been explained in the classical text. Say for example, the person is suffering from shwasa, give him some shwasagna dravya, which has been explained in the textbook in the format of shwasa kuta ras or whatever you want to give with to that particular patient, and he will respond well. But in case the textbook has explained about the shrotu moola chikitsa, what is the significance of moola and to that of rasaushadis? Whenever you have a patient of shwasa here, try to select a drug which is a shwasagna and also which is protecting the shwasa or pranava shrotu moola. Pranava shrotu sa moolam hridaya dashadamanyaha. So you select such a drug which is a shwasahara and also it is hridya, then the action of that particular drug will be very high in the patient. One such a drug is abraka. It is hridya, it is shwasahara. So such drugs should be selected. This is third protocol. The fourth protocol is very specific with the lakshana, emergency managements, where we use Portalis. Most of the times I use most of the Portalis in my clinical practice. So these are the things like the Vidya Lakshana, where we find many emergency management, or the Rajavidya. It is the treatment protocol is said to be for the kings. Nowadays every person is a king. We cannot neglect either of them. So better I treat simple rhinitis to oncology only with Portalis as a prime outset. Next. The first one is a Pranava Shrotas. Next. This is from the textbook, what is moola, lakshanas and the treatment protocol. Next. Shrota dushti lakshana and vidya lakshana. Next. Chikitsa sutra, these are the shwasahara dravyas which are explained in the textbooks. These are all shwasa. If you want to go with the ekandravya prayoga, either of these drugs can be selected. You got a wide range of drugs which you can use. It's not like you have to, because my teacher has prescribed shwasa kutaras, I have to write only shwasa kutaras. No. Either of these things are there in a protocol from the textbooks. So either of these things can be used. Next. These are all the shwasa chikitsa. Next. This is a case of a patient wherein he had a CA of lungs. Added with that, the pericardium was affected, pericardial effusion was seen. You can see the PET scan of this particular patient. The sizes of the tumors is being mentioned, like you see 17 into 18 mm, 11 into 10 into 10, and you had nearly the metastasis alone in the chest nearly to 8 to 12 places. And after this particular patient, I say he had an emergency, like he has to be addressed for a pericardial effusion. He was being tapped and later it was diagnosed in the biopsy like he was a malignant patient. Then the 2D echo and other details were being done, including the PET scan, and these were the PET scan reports. And after this, what we did is we started him with, it is pranava shrotas being affected and it is a malignant condition. These are the tumors which are to be shrunken or necrotized. So I asked using them with Vishagarbha Kottali. Vishagarbha Kottali is nothing but all the arsenic preparations. You have Aratala, Gauripashana, everything there in Vishagarbha Kottali. So we have taken Vishagarbha Kottali. Ojas is lost. So Hemagarbha portal is being added. It is an immunomodulator, and also add to that it is Ojovartaka. So on that grounds, we have started with Hemagarbha portali, Vishagarbha portali, and we have given Varunali Kvata as an Anupanam because it is indicated in Tridoshaja Gulma, and added to that it is Antha Vidrati like Lakshana. So Rasaratna Samuchaya speaks about a preparation called as a Sarveshwara Parpati in Antha Vidrati Adhikara. So Sarveshwara Parpati was being given to this particular patient. The patient is alive, and almost from past 6 years, I guess, he's totally fine today. And you can see the PET scan and see the thorax of the same patient after 6 months. Next. This is a report. Next. This is a close-up of the same report. It has been zoomed. You can see the sizes of the tumors are not there. Multiple tumors have been disappeared. You have only one anterior and medial mediastinal mass. That was a question mark. Possibly it might be a germ cell tumor. Possibly it might be a germ cell tumor. Or else it has been addressed well. All the PET scan report of the previous, which was around 6 months back, and this one is totally different. And the patient is physically fine right from the day one. He's been fine only after the pericardial effusion was from the modern support. The rest of the treatment protocol was only through the Saushatis. And the patient is alive and is going with the treatment. When I showed about this particular report, the authorities have claimed like possibly the first PET report is wrong. It's from the HCG company. How can it be wrong? He told, no, we have to, we would have done possibly in a different company. So when a patient comes to me, should I ask him for my research protocol to go with PET scan from 4 or 5 companies? It's not possible. Literally, it's not possible. But physically, I'm concerned like the patient is fine. That's the most important event. He's out of the illness. That's very important. Next phase. The most neglected shrotas in the clinical setup, the Udakava shrotas. Next. We think so it is something related to water and start giving the patient with lots of water and etc. I'll say, no, don't treat it on the grounds. Of course, you have the Trishna Chikitsa. Next. Next. Trishna Nivarana, give him Rajata and Gunja. Unfortunately, Rajata might be somewhere you would have seen in any of the practices. Gunja, no one uses it. It's a very unfortunate protocol. It's a wonderful drug clinically, I'll say. You have a patient with Shotha. You have a patient with Shotha. Gunja is a wonderful drug. Shotha because of any reasons. I will say it's not because of some reason or it is related to Udakava Shrotas. Any reason Shotha is there, give him Gunja. It addresses well the situation. So either you can give Rajata with the Gunja or Rajata and Gunja to all the cases of Udakava Shrota Vyadhi. Next. 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 Yeah. These are the Annava Shrotas, and the treatment protocol claimed by Charaka is about the Amavikara. Of course, every drug in Rasa Shastra treats Ama just because of the reason the Bhasma Nirmana is given by giving Agni Samskara. Samskaram Gunantaradhanam. Agni is an inbuilt quality of all the Bhasmas because of its Samskara. When you put up, because of Puta, you find that Agni Tattva is essential quantity of all the Bhasmas. And whenever you give these Bhasmas to the patient, this Agni Tattva has been inbuilt in the patient, which cures his illness like Ama Pachana. It causes Deepana and Pachana of that particular condition.